Good afternoon, everyone. I have a very, less time today, but there's a lot of information I'd like to share on our platform called Adobe Document Cloud and how specifically the Document Cloud can be helpful for any customers. This slide deck is mostly focusing on retail banking, but this could be across any financial services institution. So some of the key priorities for mostly retail banks, obviously, is to retain customer loyalty. So you want to ensure that the experiences that you're providing to your customers is really good. The other thing that you want to make sure is that you're quick at doing your business. You're quick at managing contracts or getting your onboarding for your customers done quickly. So there's an essence for speed as well. And then, of course, you want to make sure, as the earlier speaker mentioned about how conforming to the regulatory environment here and the Indian IT Act is very important, as well as the other SEBI and RBI regulations also need to be adhered when it comes to any such process. So it's important to make sure these are in place. But today we live in a world where experiences matter more than ever. Everybody is accustomed now to using their mobile phones for literally everything. So they're wondering, why can't they manage their bank processes through their mobile devices? And that is hopefully what we're hoping to empanel now many of the banks. So some of the benefits that come from digitizing your entire process, whether it is internal or external, is that you can reduce the amount of time it takes to sign loan agreements. Like, for example, we've seen banks who've gone from 14 days to 14 hours, and they've gained more visibility and more compliance in the process of digitization as well. And of course, you're providing a better service to your customers. And that's another, like we say, experience is a huge differentiator for many brands that are out there. So you want to make sure your customers are, having the best in class in terms of, expectations. And of course, you want to make sure today everything is mobile friendly. You do so much on mobile devices. Why not be able to provide a consent in a manner in which is acceptable by law in India? Why not be able to do that via mobile as well? And that is something that we're hoping to provide with our solution. Of course, once you've implemented this, we've seen, you'll see a tremendous increase in the speed at which you could get signatures. You're not relying on papers being sent out anymore or filling up the wrong details and then having to go back and forth. There's a ton of time that's saved. And of course, with time being saved, you're eventually going to save a lot of money as well. So there is an ROI that comes in here as well. Beyond that, you also get increased visibility into the entire process. Everything is auditable. There's accountability for each and every process and consent when it's provided. It's obviously a lot more faster. So therefore, you turn out to be a lot more productive. The risk is reduced. As I said, we ensure top-notch security in terms of encryption of all the data and documents that are shared, and also compliance with the regulatory requirements here in India. And of course, the best part about this is, it's mobile friendly. So you could pretty much any device that has a browser is good enough to transact, whether it's, providing a signature in some form with Aadhaar authentication, or whether it is, just saying an approval for a certain internal process or something. And of course, the entire experience is also a lot more better. You can use any device, you're free. It's just like, how everyone is accustomed to Netflix or Hotstar or YouTube. They're accustomed to that experience of being able to consume things on any device and having that freedom to move. And that is essentially what we're hoping to provide with our solution as well. If you look at the entire life cycle of a document, so right from when you're creating documents and converting them into PDF, we play a role in each of these different buckets here. So in the creation and initiation of the documents, and then once you, of course, then you want to manage whether you want to collaborate with your other peers in the team, or if you want to route it for certain approvals internally, or you want to put some sort of a logic to it. If the purchase order is within so-and-so amount, go to so-and-so manager, otherwise go. So those kind of things can also be managed with our collaboration with various Microsoft products as well. And of course, you know, the final execution of the document, whether it's, you know, going for approval, whether it's an internal process, or it's a sign, or it's going to an, you know, just for acknowledgement or maybe archival. So throughout this process, you want to make sure that you have security, you're compliant, and you have analytics of how your data is moving, and that you can manage all of this. And then below that, we also have an underlying layer of APIs and services that allow you to then connect with other third-party vendors in case you need your documents to be, you know, to be shared with those systems as well. Here are some use cases that I've got out. Now, these are specific to retail banking, considering the audience today. But, you know, our solution is quite flexible, and wherever there is paper being used and you need accountability for, you know, someone providing consent or signature, that's where our solution can basically fit in. So regardless of which use case, whether it's anything that you're seeing on the screen or something that's not on the screen right now, can also be supported. Of course, there are certain requirements as per the Indian IT Act where which transactions you can digitize and which you can't. And I've got a slide on that, and I'll share that as well. But here is in terms of security and compliance. So we make sure you know, we've got ISO certification, we've got PCI, which is basically the payment card industry certification. And then we've also got FedRAMP and biopharma as well, something which was added recently this year, as well as GDPR. And also, our solution is integrated with the with Aadhaar here in India in order to ensure compliance with the Indian IT Act. So the Indian IT Act recognizes an electronic signature provided you meet these five conditions. And those five conditions have to be met. There is no negotiating there. Or else you can use the previous digital signatures, which is the one where you download tokens and, you know, you buy the certificate from a certifying authority and then attach that using the USB. The problem with digital signatures is it's not very mobile friendly. You have to be on a desktop or a laptop, and you can't use your mobile device. You're relying on your own system to do that. And so electronic signatures is an evolution of digital signatures, which gives that freedom to use any device. Now, if you're using electronic signatures, the IT Act says that we must be able to prove that the signatures are unique to the signatory. So these are certificate-based digital IDs. The signatory should have control over the data when they're signing it, which is also something that we record and keep in our audit report. Any alteration to the document should be detectable. So if anybody is making any change to the document, to the agreement, to the onboarding form, whatever it is, it should be detectable. And so we have this tamper. There's a blue ribbon that comes on PDF files that is our guarantee that you know, document has not been tampered with or edited in any shape or form. And of course, throughout this journey, in case there's a dispute and you're dragged into the court of law, you need to be able to show accountability. You need to be able to show you know, who signed where. So that is where we have an audit report as well, which can be produced, which will record things like the IP address, the mobile number, and things like the Aadhaar number, masked Aadhaar number, so on and so forth, in order to help prove you know, who signed the document. And then last, what they also say that there should be a signing certificate, which is recognized by the controller of certifying authorities in India. So we've tied up with eMudra to provide these certificates to us. And I'll show you that in a bit more detail. But this is what the steps look like. Now, obviously, if you'd like to learn more, please reach out to us. I'd love to take you through this in detail. But right now, just since I have a few minutes left, just to show you, here are the different steps that go in, let's say, filling up a form. So here you see step one is when the bank is sending out the form. Step two, creating all the different fields and sending it out. Step three, it's sent out. Step four, it reaches you know, the candidate or who the customer who's filling it up can fill it up on any device. They can sign it, as you can see on the step five. They can sign it on there. But then how do we know it is actually this person who has signed it? So that is when step six comes into play. So what happens in step six is after you sign, you are then directed, or rather redirected, to the NSDL page. So NSDL is our ESP here. And what we do is we route all our calls through NSDL towards UIDAI. So what we'll do is we'll send out a call to NSDL. NSDL will then ask for the virtual ID number or the Aadhaar number of the customer. Customer will enter their Aadhaar number or virtual ID number there. Immediately, they would be sent an SMS on their Aadhaar registered mobile phone, which they will then enter in the OTP box that you see there. And only once they enter that, the correct details will there be then authenticated as the right signer. And then they will be allowed, as you can see in step eight, the transaction is then complete. And after the transaction is complete, if you look at the document, so you see that document there, I've highlighted it on the left, that blue ribbon. So that's our guarantee. That's the guarantee, that's the certificate, that's our guarantee that this document has not been tampered with or edited in any shape or form. If you click on the signature panel, you'll get additional details of who's provided that signature. For many Indian customers, excuse me, eMudhra is our certifying authority worldwide. We also have VeriSign providing a certificate. So for many Indian customers, eMudhra provides a certificate. For customers outside of India, we have VeriSign that provides is our certifying authority. Finally, just to give you a little snapshot of what's actually happening in the background, I don't want to get too technical right now. I actually can't afford to with the amount of time that I have left. But nevertheless, excuse me. What happens here is, as soon as you request for an OTP, we send a call out to NSDL, who will then send that a call out to UIDAI, who will then send an OTP to the Aadhaar registered number of the candidate, of the recipient, of signer. Once they receive that OTP, they enter that. Then the signature is then shared from NSDL. And then finally, around here, at step seven, eMudhra will then provide a certificate as well. That is to ensure that the document is not cannot be modified. And then once that is bound with the document, it sends that and voila, you're done. That's pretty much it. So all of this is happening in the back end, and it happens in a matter of seconds, really. And so that's what it's about. And basically, I've only spoken about Sign so far. But as you can see, the document cloud platform has got other applications, APIs, services as well. Love to talk more about it in detail if you'd love to do that later. And then this is the slide that talks about our ready-made integration. So if you're using any of these logos within your organization, then be rest assured that we've already got plugins that sit within these applications so that you don't even need any implementation effort that would be needed to then stitch those things together. Some of our customers using this across the world, we just signed up TSB Bank in the UK last month, and they've been using this as well. And look forward to have many Indian logos on this slide the next time I present. And also, on a last note, just to let you know, we're a global company. We've got data centers across the globe. All Indian customers automatically are provisioned in the Indian data center. So all your data is in the country, maintaining data sovereignty laws of India. So you don't have to worry about your data going out. Finally, we've been via Adobe. Many of you might know us as a PDF company. We've been around for more than 20 years. We've got some of the best integrations, enterprise support. And as you can see with Acrobat and Document Cloud, we've got the end-to-end digital workflow right from inception until the archival of the document. So guys, that was a quick, concise view of Adobe and how we can help you guys out in your digitization journeys. So my name is Guru Vaidya again. Would love to have a more detailed dive or talk chat with you guys. Please reach out to the team and we'd love to have a chat with you. I hope you guys found this presentation useful. It's back to you, Shikha. Thank you all. Thank you.